Dear Zoology, first semester. Dear student, today we are here to discuss nitrogen cycle. As we have discussed in our previous lecture about biogeochemical cycle, it is the specific pathway by which a chemical substance moves through biotic and abiotic factors. In example, we have carbon cycle, nitrogen cycle, water cycle, and many others. Nitrogen cycle. Nitrogen cycle is the way that nitrogen in nature is changed into many different forms that are used by the living organism. As we know that at least nitrogen in 78% in air is present. Nitrogen chemicals are needed for life. Nitrogen is necessary part of proteins, DNA, and RNA. In plants, nitrogen is needed for photosynthesis and growth. So, living things cannot use the elemental nitrogen in the air for these things. That is the reason it will have to change into different forms by which it can be used properly. Here we have five stages by which this use can be possible. Number one, we have nitrogen fixation. Nitrogen fixation is needed to change the nitrogen in air into forms that can be used by life. Most nitrogen fixation is done by microorganism called bacteria. These bacteria have enzyme that combines nitrogen with hydrogen gas to make ammonia. Some of these bacteria live in the roots of the plants, mostly family legume. In these roots, they make ammonia for the plant and the plant gives them carbohydrate. Other plants take nitrogen compounds out of the soil through their roots. All nitrogen in animals comes from eating plants. Nitrogen assimilation. Nitrogen assimilation is the formation of organic nitrogen compounds like amino acids from inorganic nitrogen compounds present in the environment. Organisms like plants, fungi, and certain bacteria that cannot fix nitrogen gas depends on the ability to assimilate nitrate or ammonia for their needs. Third stage, we have nitrogen ammonification. Ammonium in soil is made by nitrogen fixing bacteria and decomposers. Bacteria and fungi that break down dead life into its parts, this process is called ammonification. Ammonium has a positive charge. It easily joins to clay and humus in the soil. Ammonia and ammonium are poisonous to fish and other animals. Sewage and other wastewater is regularly measured because of this. If ammonia levels are too high, nitrification must happen. Nitrification is the next stage of nitrogen cycle. Nitrification is the oxidation of ammonia and ammonium to nitrite and then to nitrate by bacteria, because nitrite and nitrate have a negative charge, so they do not easily join to soil and will wash out of the soil during rain and irrigation. High nitrate levels in drinking water is harmful for babies and can cause flu baby syndrome. High nitrate level can also cause too much algae growth in lakes and pools. This eutrophication can be harmful to fish and other water animals. The use of fertilizers is controlled because of this. Last stage, but not the least one, is denitrification. When there is no oxygen, some bacteria will make nitrate into nitrogen gas to extract energy. This starts the nitrogen cycle over again. This process is called denitrification. Now comes on importance of nitrogen. As we know that nitrogen is an essential plant nutrients. Second, all living things need nitrogen for amino acids, proteins, and nucleic acid. Third one, concentration of nitrogen are important indicator of water quality. Fourth one, excess nitrogen also affects air quality and human health. In the end, I want to say that unfortunately, human activity has altered this cycle. We do this by adding nitrogen into the soil with fertilizer, as well as other activities that put more nitrous oxide gas into the atmosphere. This adds in more nitrogen than is needed by normal cycle and upsets the cycle's balance. Thank you.